Hello everybody, welcome to today's video. In this video, we are going to talk about how can you crack a data analyst job. Okay, let's talk through three things. Number one, what does a data analyst actually do? Number two, what are the skills required? And number three, let's walk through a job description to understand how and what the recruiters are looking for. And finally, let's combine all these elements so that we know what you should be working on. Okay, so let's get started with the definition of what does a data analyst actually do. Now, a simple definition of what a data analyst actually does on a day-to-day basis indicates that these guys have the knowledge and the skill to turn raw data into information and insight, okay, which can then be used to make business decisions. These are the last two lines in the definition, right? The role of a data analyst can be defined as someone who has the knowledge and skills to turn raw data, right? So, a data analyst should have the ability to interact with that data. Now, that ability can come from learning Microsoft Excel, Google Sheets, or probably a little more advanced tools such as Python, R, SPSS, so on and so forth, right? Then the second part of the equation for a data analyst indicates that, hey, they can then take this raw data into information and insight, which can be used to make business decisions, right? So it is not just about working with data, but also the ability to draw insights and say to the business that, hey, this is what the data means, and this is what you should be doing to the entire context of that particular business decision. Make sense? So let's move forward and understand what are the skills required to be effective data analyst. Okay. According to MIT, they say that every data analyst should possess a combination of two skills, technical and leadership. Now, if we talk about technical skills, this is something that we have already talked about. A database language such as SQL, R, or Python, spreadsheet tools such as Microsoft Excel or Google Sheets, and also data visualization software such as Tableau or Qlik, right? Now, you consume data from a big database, then you do some simple math on top of it, and then finally you present it to the executives either through PowerPoint or through a dashboard in Tableau, right? So this is what you would be doing. Now, then what does the leadership skill mean? Leadership skills prepare a data analyst to complete decision-making and problem-solving tasks, okay? Jump into the last sentence here, or the last but one sentence, you will see that the data analysts track the most important metrics for their projects. They also diagnose problems that may be occurring, and they also predict how different courses of actions could address a problem. Now, what does this mean? This means that they are not just going and interacting with the data, but they are also talking to the business and telling that, hey, potentially this is the action that you need to be taking based on what the data indicates. Okay, so these are the two skills. Again, the leadership skill is about understanding the business, and that comes a little bit with domain knowledge and expertise. But if you can show that, hey, you are proficient in the technical tools, or you have awareness about the technical tools, then these data analyst jobs are not that difficult to crack. Okay, let's jump into one of the job descriptions from one of the topmost organizations in the world for a data analyst role. Okay, I was going through the data analyst jobs that are available in my city, Hyderabad, and the first one that I found was from Amazon. Okay, so Amazon posted a data analyst job requirement 6 days back. Okay, now if we look at what are the basic qualifications required, they are saying that a basic bachelor's degree, experience of working in a similar role, exposure to Excel and SQL, deadline driven team player, strong analytical problem solving, must be detail oriented, experience in a highly analytical results oriented environment, so on and so forth, right? Now, you need to match these basic qualifications. Now, this is at one of the best companies in the world, right? And the only requirement that they are saying is, hey, you need to have exposure to Excel and SQL. And the only requirement that they are saying is you need to have exposure to Excel and SQL. And subsequently, you need to have 1 year experience in a similar setup, right? Now, if you probably leave Amazon and if you go for any of the other roles, right, a data analyst at State Street, if you have a data analyst at Wipro, Microsoft, Experian, so bunch of different data analyst roles at some of these really, really big companies, right? And all they have is the basic requirement of Excel and SQL, right? If you need to build that 1 year experience, you can probably do some projects, or you can probably go work with a startup to build that relevant exposure and go ahead and apply to these jobs. If you already have some kind of exposure towards a strategy role or a decision making role in a startup, you can go ahead and apply to these data analyst roles if you know a little bit of SQL, and you can learn SQL through any of the online learning platforms. Okay, now if you go into preferred qualification is nothing but exactly the similar, but they are asking having exposure to analytical platforms such as R, Python, AWS, because it's Amazon, of course, right? These are the skills that are required. That's it. So if you can develop a decent enough proficiency, these are asking only about exposure. Okay, there might be some difficult interviews along the way. Amazon is probably tough to crack, but you see on the left hand side, there are a lot of job opportunities in some of these biggest companies in the world, right? You take these job opportunities, you see what are the job requirements, go ahead and apply. I've did analysis of almost 8 to 10 such kind of job opportunities, and I realized that all they're asking is basic proficiency or exposure towards SQL, exposure towards Excel, exposure towards R, Python. That's it. And if you have at least a decent experience in any of these fields, it's very easy to crack these jobs. Now, let me also share with you that a job description template that I have found for data analyst roles. Okay. Now, what does this indicate? This job description template briefly indicates that, hey, the responsibilities of a data analyst, it is interpreting data, analyzing results, using statistical techniques, and acquiring data from primary or secondary data sources, right? This is one. The job responsibilities, okay, or the job requirements, all they are asking is proven working experience, right? Probably a year experience in a startup or in any other company would also do. Knowledge of statistics and experience using statistical packages such as Excel, okay? Excel is considered to be a statistical package, so not very difficult. And strong knowledge of and experience with reporting packages, databases, programming languages, so on and so forth, right? So this is a generic job description template for a data analyst role, and you can see that, hey, it's not too difficult, or the requirements are not very difficult from what we have talked about. Just to give you an insight, me and Professor Ekaterina, we are running a 8-week course at an intersection of machine learning and strategy, so that you pick up the basics of data science, right, and also basics of strategy, so that you pick up both technical and also strategy skills, and you apply for these kind of roles. If you are interested, please check out the link in the description box. Looking forward to seeing you guys again soon. Thank you so much, guys. If you have liked this video, please press on the like button. Thank you.